the story and the journey that I like doing for people and sharing with them is capturing the spirit of the human journey, the human journey of creativity, which has been on this for 100,000 years since we started scratching things on rock. And now, in a lot of ways, I get to be a modern caveman and work with modern tools and metals and be able to create things that have simplistic messages, spiritual messages about energy, about flow, about relating to the architecture of the land around you. So what I'm going to do today is I'll take you on a little process. I'm trying to develop some life-size figures representing the human being rising up, just like a sprout, just like a bean sprout in a garden. So in that journey, everything has energy lines, and everything has movement. And so I'm going to draw today on a little bit here a mock-up of what goes in the large. You gotta have a really good lure. I sometimes akin these things to this little human spirit lures. You know, you look at them and you go, well, I don't know why I want to go after this thing, but you want it. You know, you just, it's kind of like a little lure. More of that means I don't know. It's like just up to the eye of the old.
So if you didn't get a chance to check it out, make sure you do after the show. Also, thank you to Sarah Cochran's piano student, Allison Stevens, for the wonderful pre-show entertainment. I'm Sean Goffman, and I'm the executive director of PACA as a volunteer. The Chewelah Performing and Cultural Arts Board of Directors and staff are dedicated to the mission of bringing together leadership and resources to create and sustain a center of excellence for the performing and cultural arts here in Chewelah. Our board members are present in our audience and backstage as well, and our architect, Tom Bristol, is also here with us tonight. Will the board please stand up? I don't know if you can see them out there, but thank you, board members, for all of you do. We love our city center. Many of us involved with PACA spend a lot of hours here in this building each year presenting shows and helping other groups with lighting, staging, and presentations of all kinds. This space is owned and operated by the City of Chewelah to serve many functions, and it will remain a multiple-use space and gymnasium available for rental by many different groups. We couldn't get in here to do this show until 3 o'clock today because it was rented to another group. PACA will continue to rent the facility, support the arts groups that use it, and help in any way that we can to assist the city in fulfilling the demands placed upon the Civic Center. But PACA's long-term dream is to have a center dedicated to the arts, with appropriate seating, ventilation, restrooms, and accommodations. After 7 years, remains the same. We will make our plans public when they are further developed and closer to reality. We'd like to thank all of you for your past and present support, and we hope you will join us in keeping our dream alive. PACA will keep planning, and we intend to fulfill our mission. Let's make one thing perfectly clear. We are not focused on bringing arts and culture to Chewelah. It's already here. Backstage to perform to you tonight. Tonight we're going to showcase some of our talent. We hope you enjoy the program and appreciate the effect of all of our participants. We would like to dedicate this evening's performance to last year's featured artist, Aaron Gabriel. We appreciate his dedication to the arts and would like to honor Aaron by donating the proceeds of this program to his wife, Melanie, and son, Griffin, who are also here with us tonight. And now, on with the show. Like father and like son, Forrest Govier has established himself as an artist in music, and his band gave an excellent performance last year at Event 6. We are excited that he can fit us into his schedule again this year. Forrest recently joined Anna Popovic at the Bing Crosby Theater in Spokane. We gladly welcome him back to perform for Event 7. Let's have a big hand for Forrest Govier. Thank you. I would come out and sing that song, but I don't know it. We're going to give out the first award of the evening. Here to hand out the awards, we have the Distinguished Young Woman of 2013, Naomi Miller, with alternates Josie Mott and Patty Murray. Give them a big hand. This is a huge award.
I was walking by the old armory building, and a voice said, "Build it, and they will come." I looked around and said, "What?" Again, I heard the voice, "Build it, and they will come." "Who will come?" I asked.
The voice replied, "Artists, dancers, and painters, and the thespian." And I looked around, and over by the side of the building, I saw Tom Bristol, and he said, "Build it, and they will come." And then he said, "Make sure the restrooms are up to code."
And the computer on the sound system. You gotta make sure that's okay. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of you who voted for the award. The Chewelah Independent publishes the ballot for us every year, and for this we would like to acknowledge their support by offering a big thank you. Thank you, Chewelah. We always look forward every year to the Northern Ballet and Performing Arts performance at the event. Always professional and elegant, we thank Anne Benedict and her ballet students for their continued support. Tonight, they are here to perform an excerpt from Sleeping Beauty. Give them a big hand. Soon. We would like to recognize the efforts of the radio station and the impact it has on our community by featuring a finalist from the 2013 Chewelah's Got Talent that was done right here on the stage. It was produced by the radio station in 2013. Here's our very own Meredith Keary in here tonight to perform Dream a Little Dream of Me. Let's give her a big hand.
Thank you. Concert.
Jenkins High School Christmas Concert.
Jenkins High School Veterans Day concert.
Yes, elementary choir concert.
Yeah, we didn't go up with.
And the winner is Jenkins High School Jazz in the Park.
On behalf of all of the girls and the students at the high school, thank you very much. The reason why those are so hard to open, they've been hermetically sealed in a mayonnaise jar in George Ebert's spring house for the last 3 months. If you enjoyed your high school prom, then you will want to attend the awesome 80s prom at Jenkins High School. Come and help choose the prom king and queen, and you can dance your heart out to your favorite 80s music in this interactive production. Here from Jenkins High School Theater, awesome 80s prom. Give a big hand.
Well, what that means, dudes, is that your butts are mine until you have that diploma in your hand. Now, here are the Snellgrovian rules for tonight's festivities. Number one, no drinking. Number two, no smoking. Cheech and Chong. Number three, no dirty dancing. I'm talking to you, Umbada lady. Are we clear? Are we clear? And now a word from your head of prom committee, Melissa and Martin.
Till Beth Do Us Part in January. Here to perform a scene from this play, is Sophia Olos and Bill Indiana Barnes. Give them a big hand. Presenters are excellent representatives of our next award. Both have been players with Spacetime Theater right here in this very building. Here to present the outstanding theatrical performance is Bob Stevens and Allison. And the winner is Chewelah's Got Talent, Chewelah's Community Radio, KCW.
Someone said Hogan leaned over and said, get a speech ready. You're all in trouble because whenever I get a microphone, I have an overwhelming compulsion to do the weather. Tonight it'll be 20 degrees, tomorrow 40 and rainy. It's going to rain money. You have to pick it all up and give it to PACA. Kudos for Chewelah's Got Talent to my ex-wife Shelley because it was her brainchild and she did an awesome job putting it all together. All I did was talk. I want to let everybody know that the first Saturday in May, Chewelah's Got Talent 2 will have contests for to qualify for the first two Saturdays before that. So May 8th, plan on. All right? Thanks very much.
Stage Time Theater School, Bugsy Malone.
Jenkins High School, The Diary of Anne Frank.
Jenkins High School, Grease.
Stage Time Theater School, Tom Sawyer.
The Envelope, Grease.
Like
soon, this Friday, as a matter of fact, the Woodlands Theater production of Secret Garden in Kettle Falls is directed by Sean Pavlov. Performing the song, If I Had a Fine White Horse, is Stasia Richmond singing to cast member Lily Cherry. Give them a warm welcome.
Seems to me not much. Volunteer Award is for a volunteer who has gone above and beyond for PACA. We would like to honor Scott Schlafman for his work encouraging and showcasing the artist and artists in Chewelah. Scott, through Chewelah Community Radio, KCHW 102.7 FM, has recorded events for playback at a later time, which he's doing tonight, too. Interviewed actors, directors, and promoters on the radio, which helped spread the word about cultural and performing activities in Chewelah. We are so grateful Scott moved to Chewelah and had a seemingly impossible dream to have a community radio alive in Chewelah. Scott Schlafman.
Another speech. I want to thank PACA for all the support. It's been a challenge. We've got a great board of directors. I know Tom Walters is out there. Thank you, Tom. Lynn Husband, Shelly Schlafman, and Terry Slavin. I want to thank them for helping out. It's and all the nonprofit groups, the Arts Guild as well. We've all kind of come together and helping each other, and that's what makes it work here in Chewelah. Thank you.
Presenters for this evening's biggest award, the prestigious PACA Award, are PACA President Sharon Ludwig and Janet McLaughlin. Janet and Sharon have a long-time working theater relationship as well as friendship. Janet was last year's recipient of this award. Please help me welcome Sharon and Janet.
Structures and working as a general contractor for 30 years in our area. He
He also spent time as the building inspector for Chewelah and Calvin. Tom worked with Kevin Kernan, teaching design graphic communication classes at Jenkins High School, emphasizing design to vo-tech students. Two of those students Tom mentored were my son, David Ludwig, and Cameron Stroyan on their senior project when they designed and built the information kiosk that's in Chewelah City Park. Projects in the community include residential and light commercial projects, developing Central Park in Chewelah, designing and building tennis courts in Chewelah at the golf course and the high school, designing the Chewelah Park Center Stage and the Rotary Pavilion and Stage in the Calder Park, working on the historical renovation to the Stevens County Courthouse, designing both restrooms in the Chewelah City Park, and remodeling and continued renovations through the Chewelah Arts Guild to the Civic Center. Tom has served our community through the Chewelah Planning Commission for 20 years, being the chairperson for 15 years. He's been active in the Chewelah Arts Guild since the beginning and is the current president. Tom also serves the Chewelah community through PACA, which he has been the architectural advisor since the beginning. Tom plans on continuing to be active in the Chewelah arts community by serving as the Arts Guild president, helping PACA get a theater, and will help with restrooms and ADA improvements to this civic center. Tom is always on the lookout for more ways to stay useful and enjoy life. Tom, we consider you a great friend and know that our community is a better place because you are here. Thank you for all you do. May we present Tom Bristol.
I enjoy helping create and set and place the spaces where art experience can happen. Most of my artistic expression is in this area. Many times it comes down to simply infrastructure maintenance and repair. This work is somehow artistically satisfying to me, and knowing that it helps others. It will be very satisfying, and I would have appreciated this work if we received it after having thank you, PACA, and thank you to the artists. And our hearts are very open. The PACA honors the this event to be here in Health County. Thank you.
Thank you.
Group in our community works hard to keep our talented arts community members in the spotlight. Each complements the other, and through this combination of forces, we go together like Grandma Lama King. Grandma Lama can ding the ding dong. And I said, here to perform We Go Together from Greece is J.H.S. Drama, give a big hand.
Thank you.
so many people in attendance and to celebrate the talent in our community. At this time, we'd like to have Naomi Miller, this distinguished young woman, bring up the art created by our featured artist, David Gomadier. He has graciously donated a piece of his art. And we're going to auction it off right now. Naomi? Bring it up. Oh, it's a howling coyote. Is it a horse? I see that it's a horse. It's a horse, of course. Beautiful. We're going to start the bidding at $100. Give me $100. $100, I hear. Give me $110. For a good cause, $110 right there. Let's go to $120. We got $120 back there. $130. Give me $130. Come on, this goes for a great deal more money. Twice this in a studio. We got it back here? At $130. $140. $140 going one right there. We got $150? Okay. $150. $160. Can I get it back? $200. We got a $200 bid on the piece. This is a one-of-a-kind original David Gomadier. And you can say you got it here tonight, but he was our special guest. Our bid is $200. $210? $250. We have $250. On the table right now. Anybody else? $275? Yeah. $275. We got $275. Go give us three. $300. We got $300 for the cause. $325? Going $325. $350. We got $350 right now. We'll give you $375. $350. $350 is the bid. Put your hand down there, back down there, high school students. Put your hand down, Janet. $350. Is that the bid? Who's got the bid here? $350. Right here? $350. We got a $350 bid for a very good cause. It's going once. $400 on this original David Gomadier piece. And I bet he'd let you take a picture with him. $410 right here. This is a very good day. $420. We got $420. We got to kick it right on out. $420. $430. Hit $430 right here. $430. $420 going once. $420 going twice. He said $420, $430. $430. So, $430. We'd like to take this opportunity to thank these people who contributed these tickets. Some lucky winner will get to attend one of these wonderful performances over the next 3 months. The certificates can be redeemed to any show by presenting it at the door. Here we go, Tracy.
Woo!
Judy Graham? Has been an inspiration to all of us that he went to Stanford, He's an architect. He can choose to live anywhere he wants to live and make a living. And he chooses to be here. And he chooses to be present every day to help us be better. So thank you all for coming. There's food back there. Stop and talk with the audience.